Hi guys, this is Lego Yoshi, and welcome back to my playthrough of Banjo-Kazooie. Now you may be wondering, why are we in this room? Well, somebody, a few videos ago, unlocked a Jiggy, but decided to completely forget about it. The one in the witch's eye. So, first things first, we are going to quickly go and get that. It's not a hard Jiggy to get hold of, but it uses the same format they have to use for the Freeze Easy Peak Jiggy, in which you have to unlock the flight pad and the use the running boots as well. Yeah, I realised when I was just before I started recording that I'd actually forgotten about it. So, oops. Right. See if we can do this and go. Miss me. Use the flight pad, there we go. Now what we need to do is use the beat bomb, because for some strange reason the witch has got glass in her eyes. So we use that to smash it, and then simply land in the eye and grab it. Not terribly difficult, but like I say, some people who find that bit a bit tough or challenging, then you can kind of understand that they're going to struggle. I don't know why I'm going that way. There is two other things that I want to do before I actually go to unlock the last world. One of them I'm probably going to struggle with because I cannot remember how you do it off the top of my head. The other one is it's actually the Rusty Bucket Bay Jiggy, which I'm trying to remember if it's actually up here. It is. That's easy enough to get. I actually thought this one had a time-based puzzle with it, so that's the reason why I found it's for something else. For what I'm going to do now anyway. So, there we go, we have all the 10 gold feathers. Can we get from here? Yes we can. Looked a little bit suspect. What's up here? Here is the third water switch. Now, I need to remember off the top of my head which way I need to go, so just give me a second while I'm just looking it up. We've only got 30 seconds to do this, so we need to swim down. Go into the area where Rusty Bucket Bay is, which is from here obviously, and then we need to swim up, from what I've just read, to the right, so it should be up here. Is that it there? Nope, it's even further up. I'm going to have to hurry because I've only got 7 seconds, 4 seconds. There it is. Yes, just. And what do we have up here? We have the final Cheeto. Bed and Bird getting good at finding Cheeto. So another spell they shall have.
A traitor book has pushed its luck. So into the burning fire I'll chuck.
Find Cheeto, which won't. Code you must enter on Sandcastle Floor in Treasure Trove Cove is golden feathers. Gold feathers.
Well, I think we can all guess what's going to happen this time. Yes, we're not all that silly, are we? It's going to double our lives. That's right, double our lives. Called it now. What do you mean double golden feathers? What sort of madness is that? I don't really know. Where do these people get these stories from? I don't know. I heard something so ridiculous. Right, one thing I am going to do is I'm going to use the warp. Make it a little bit easier. I think it's this one. Hey! You're supposed to die. You die now. Anyway. There you go. Let me jump in here. And I suppose this is the first time I was using the warps, which is quite nice. And there we go. Right, let's get to Treasure Trove Cove as quick as we can. We are going to need that warp again sometime soon, but we shall go over that a bit later. Right. Then once again, we have to go all the way to Trip Cove, patch up Leaky the Bucket, and enter our code on the floor. And move crab. There we go. Right. We all know the drill by now. Just make our way there. Find Mr. Crab. Mr. Krabs. That'd be funny if he were an enemy on this game. From SpongeBob.
Lovey money. Lovey money.
Not the best impression of Mr. Krabs, but oh well, screw it. My throat's not exactly brilliant. Yes, we know you're leaky. We've been playing for a whole game. If I can. There we go. There we go. Right. Get rid of the watch, please. There you go. Hooray! We've got rid of the water. Right. Let's get rid of this other crab. Come here, you. Come here, red belly. And there we go. Right. So, let's make a start. Where's G? Go. D. There you are. F. E. A. D. H. And finally. E. R. Gives us double gold feathers. I'm almost certainly supposed to be double lives. I'm joking. Right. Yeah, whatever. You'll give plenty of bruises, who knows. We shall see when we get to the final battle, Grunty. Anyway, let's get out of this bloody place. I'm trying to think which way we have to go, and I think I'm gonna have to use a warp again. Yeah. Otherwise, I've gotta go from all the other areas with the big bars and the next area and yada yada yada. So, excuse me.
You never saw me.
Yeah. Right, let's go and do a quick walk. Banjo. There we go. Let's gain the pot at least, please. Nope, leave me alone, you. I'm lost. Oh. Lost my marble a bit there. Anyway, so I want to I'm not using the fast run. I want to go back up here where the miners, the room that we've just been in to collect the rusty bucket bay jiggy. I want to swim up to the surface but try and get past the mine if we can. And I want to jump onto this platform. Ah! You're a lot closer than you should have been. There we go. And we need 640 notes. We surpass it by 160. Like I said, they are quite lean in this game, obviously, because it is mainly. I know a lot of kids do play this, and also use this to get through. Now we have double feathers. And there we go. So, yes, this is the area for the last world. But. Where's the jigsaw? Get out of it, bull. Well, let's climb some of these leaves, shall we, and see what we can find. Also, I just see Brentilda. 765, we can actually go through there, and that's the actual area for the final boss and other stuff. But we're not going to do that yet. Ooh, what's from here? Eggs? Is there much we need? Oops. Come here. Thank you. I've got another one. That's it. Oh, that's for a number of tokens. Right. Carry on this way. We've got a honey hive, which we don't need. The feathers, which we also didn't need at all. And there's a jigsaw switch. Remember this area, guys? All the way back near the beginning. It was a bit of a dick move, to be fair. Also, Rentilda. Oh, you shut up, Grunty. We don't care. Yep.
Gruesome Gruntilda's favourite pastime is collecting dragon teeth.
That just sounds quite interesting.
This poor guy called Undead Ed was her first and only boyfriend.
Was he a zombie? Ew.
When she was younger, Grunty used to have a greasy warthog as a pet.
Well, that doesn't surprise me. Right. There is a little secret area somewhere. I'm sure there it is. Which has a wall in it. Which is going to come in very handy. We've got a long way to go back. There we go. Probably one of the most useful warps is this one. And I want to go straight down. So although it does make you backtrack quite a fair bit, at least they give you this nice warp that will go all the way near to where you need to be. Which is always very helpful. Right. I think we've already seen that one. Anyway, so we've got 35 puzzle pieces, and it took 15 to unlock it. Click, clock, wood. Probably my third favourite world is this one. It is a really nice world. I love the idea that they had for it, which I will go through very, very shortly. But Mad Monster Mansion and Freezy's Peak for me are the best two worlds, so it's a bit unfortunate. And with the length of this level as well, it made it extremely difficult on the N64. Get everything. But I will explain all very, very shortly. First things first. He never even saw us, I don't know how he didn't. Just jump in here. Right, so let's get to Click Clock Wood, guys. And before we do anything, I just want to make sure that I've got everything else that I need. 9 out of 10 for that. That's all done. 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 Look at that bloody completion time. I am embarrassed by that, with that, what happened. Trying to find them bloody stupid notes. I don't even know what suddenly made me think of where it was. I just suddenly found it. And also, behind here, there is nothing. I would have thought that somewhere that could hide something. Right. So, here we are. Click Clock Wood. Kind of a small area, isn't it? The gimmick to this is the spring, summer, autumn, or if you're American, fall, and winter. You go through each season, one at a time, and you find the switch for them in each world. So here's the spring switch. The level in each season is the same. It's the same layout and everything, but obviously there'll be some different changes to correspond with the season. Obviously in the Xbox One, I think you have to just find the switches again, which doesn't take massively long if you do die. But in the N64, you have to do it all again, collect all the notes again, which is a pain in the backside. So, before I start, there is certain things that we need to look for in the seasons. Just give me 2 seconds, guys. In spring, we need to find 16 musical notes, 2 jiggies, and 2 jinjos. 1 jiggy I will have to leave until the end, and 1 jinjo I'll have to leave until the end. Also, my name is just need to go back. That's really comfy over here. Anyway, let's go and explore this level, shall we? Like I said, we need to remember we need to get to 16 musical notes and 2 G's. Let's have a nice swim underwater. Oh, a nice friendly beaver. Hello.
Somebody move this boulder. Naughty can't get into his house.
Oh dear. There's nothing we can do underwater. So, if you're wondering, well, sure we can help him. This is one of the gimmicks for, in every world, for example, this, you have to go back in a different season and help him. That's what it's like. If I remember rightly as well, if we plant some eggs in here, then I'm giving him back, I don't want to. Don't know how many it takes. 5, is it? Yeah. Ah, it grows a flower a bit. But it doesn't give us anything else. Just that. Oh well, never mind.
Ouchie!
Oh yeah. It's not gonna be, is it? Yeah. Take that. In your face. Hello. No one else. There is a Mumbo transformation in this level. But I will be getting him. I will be doing it, only is appearing in spring, but I'll be leaving it till the very end of the level. So I'll be doing all the seasons first, then coming back to spring for a very special reason. And also, say hello to an extremely annoying enemy. The big cluckers. Yeah. Big cluckers. I'm just going to let that sink in for a bit. Oops. Oh. Another hint I'll give you. I'll just get this Mumbo token. If you do, when you're killing the cluckers, God, there's going to be so many jokes on that, isn't there? Leave the honeycomb pieces if you have full health. Because if you fall off this tree, which is very high possibility, I do it very, very often. Because I am an idiot. Any health that you do lose, you will get straight back from these. Just like that. Ow. You jerk! Thankfully there's a way back up. No, come on. Anyway, I'm trying to think what the jiggy is and. Hey! I remember you. You're a jerk. Oops, didn't mean to collect that. Oh, must have somehow fallen. Some more notes, and I think I've actually collected all the notes already. I'm not using the gold feather to gain a gold feather, that just sounds stupid. I am not an idiot, I think. Although I've just claimed not long since that I'm actually an idiot. Yeah. Continuity. Anyway. So yeah, we're not going to go and visit Mumbo yet. I don't think he has anything that we need off the top of my head. I better go and check. My mind starts to wander. You don't want to step in that green area anyway, because they're brambles and they will hurt you. I can guarantee you I'd come in and just say, oh, I ain't even got enough for me. For, you know. I guarantee you he'd have something that I need if I didn't come and check. He's only got eggs, but we'll do that now. Right, across. And also, another one will open over here. A little alcove, which I bet that some people don't even think are looking there. Nice little hiding place. Right, so let's carry on our way. Which way do we need to go? Right, so let's continue on and carry on up the tree. How are we doing for time? We're still fine. I might make these a little bit longer levels because they are, like I said, this level is very, very long. Just an extra life and a Mumbo token. Grab the Mumbo token. I need that. Right, and we're on the way. There are some more Mumbo tokens. We can just quickly dispatch off. Like so. Ha ha, in your face. Oh god, a beehive. But we can't get in it. There's a tiny little hole somebody can get in. And it's not us. So you can probably guess that we need to go in there with the transformation. I'm not going to tell you what a transformation is yet, but I don't know. It's probably one of the better. Oh, here we go. Yep. This is what I mean by this level being quite long, especially when you keep falling. Yeah. This is the only problem I have with this level, is the constant falling. What I do. But, anyway, yes, you need to do a lot of the jumping from one bit to another, which can get annoying after a while. Honeycombs, don't need them. Right. Take two. Oh, he's done it again! If you can, try and land in the water because you don't take any damage. One good bit of inflation I can give you. Yeah, this is one thing that I hate, is if you run too far before you actually jump, by the time you've run off the edge and you press A, you just do your flood jump and you just fall straight to the ground. It's really annoying. It really is, but partly my fault, to be fair. I just want to make sure of that one. But, like I said, my fault. It's one of them things. We'll carry on. Up the tree. Whoops. Okay, I'm climbing up this. Oh, come on. Yep, the blowing slope. There we go. Take three. Like I've been saying quite a few times in this Let's Play, third time's a charm. There is actually a beehive that gives you pretty much free honey because there's no bees around it for once, which is strange for later on in the game. One thing I will say as well, anybody who's played Banjo-Tooie, like I said, in this game they make the honeycombs harder by putting the bees around it, which you can easily get around by just using the what the hell are you doing, Banjo? Slowly glitching a little bit there. But anyway, but yes, they made the honeycomb hives a bit hard to get hold of because of the bees, which is a little good idea, I suppose. It makes it a little bit harder for you to get them. In Banjo-Tooie, they make them come alive, and they come and chase after you. And I nearly missed the jump there. Only thing I will say is, my god, they scared the living hell out of me when I first saw them. They freaked me out. They really did. I just wasn't expecting it in the slightest, and it eek was the only thing. All you just have to go, oh god almighty. They just look really scary as well, because the usual eyes that they have massive red eyes to make them more evil. But, oh, hello. Aww, such a cute squirrel. I do like Nabnub. I do like squirrels as well. They are one of my favourite animals, I'd say. They're with hedgehogs and meerkats. so cute. And he looks like he's enjoying himself. I'm good. Don't need to grab that yet. Right, let's carry on up, shall we? More precision jumping. God bless you, game. Anybody thought it was a platforming game? And a nice Mumbo token. Right, and... ooh! Giant egg. Let's go and have a look at this egg, shall we? We've got a shot jump pad. If I remember anything from Bubblegut Swamp, we all know what the X means. Smash it!
The eerie, mighty eagle! Need sleep now!
Aww. Okay, you sleep then. Just don't eat me. Thank you. So yeah, once again, it's something that we're going to have to do in later levels. Well, in later seasons, shall we say. And once again, more precision jump... precision... I put my teeth back in. Precision jumping. Thank you so much, game. I hated doing this as a kid. I really did. Ah, I thought I was going to miss them. Right. And here. As you can see, we have the Jinjo. Which I can grab if I have the golden feathers, which I do have. But there is something I need to... I don't know. I'll get him. Come on. Ouchie. Oh well, it was worth it. Right, let's smash open this and see what's in here. A lot of vines. Oh, Jiggy! We're getting to the top of the tree. And also... oops. Don't disturb me. I will drop that extra life. Right, so, are we done, I think? Oh, look. We've got 20 jiggies, so that's 16. Yeah, that's fine. We've got that one. There's one jiggy that we can't get until later on, and there's one ginger we can't get until later on now I've realised. So, we are fine for spring. We shall move on to summer. And I think I'm going to have to end this video, because it's getting quite long. But anyway, thanks for watching, guys, as always, and I shall see you guys next time. See you later, guys.